had a good couple of days of practice. Guys have been good. A little disappointed, obviously, that we didn't get to play today, but I think being able to reschedule some games so quickly, I think it's given a little bit of energy.
Coach, just what have these last few days been like with the cancellation of the Florida trip and then trying to get these games in order?
Well, I think the big thing is we'd already scouted Indiana State, Omaha, and Austin Peay and all the other side schools on the other side of the bracket. So having to, step back and look and try to get back. And obviously we had a couple other false deals that we thought we might be playing. So we had pre-scouted some of the other opponents. And then once we figured out we were going to play Charlotte, going back through last year's stuff, looking at some footage from the latter part of their season, and then also getting some Belmont Abbey information.
Coach, you got to be excited to get this season started, have a team pretty close to home to go play some games and get this thing cooking this weekend.
Yeah, I mean, it's been a long time coming for our guys. I think they'll be excited. I think like with all of us, the uncertainty, at times just creates a little bit of, stop, start. And I think our guys will be excited. They should be excited. And it's going to be an interesting beginning to the season, I think, for everybody.
Joe, how long of a turnaround was this Charlotte, mini event? At what point did you start working on this with them, I guess?
Well, after the situation they had with Tennessee and VCU, I mean, we were all in situations where we had to recalibrate very quickly. And as soon as that happened, John Gilbert and Ryan Robinson got on it and talked to the people at Charlotte. And we were talking to Charlotte and VCU at one point. VCU went to Mohegan Sun, I think it was. And Charlotte and ourselves were scrambling around with probably five or six different scenarios that we were talking about. Some of the scenarios were here, some of them were there. Some came down to staffing, some came down to another opponent. So there was a lot of different things going on.
Was staying in North Carolina a priority for y'all, or was that an element of this or no?
I would think someplace regional. I don't know if it was necessarily staying in Carolina. I mean, I do think something regional with everything that's going on was a priority.
How much does the familiarity of playing Charlotte the last few seasons and last year especially help?
Well, from a scouting standpoint, we've seen, but usually at this time, you've got two tapes on exhibition games. And, they've got a bunch of new guys. They lost three stars. Now they do have Shepard, and they do have Young back. Supic is back. Supic is back. Those guys, we've seen before in person. We've seen the style of play a little bit. But some of the other guys we haven't seen, we don't know, which you prepare to in the preseason in case they do something that they haven't done previously. So there's always some uncertainties also.
So as you enter the weekend, what's the shape of your team right now physically and, with the COVID thing going on and all this, what's the latest?
Well, I think we're in pretty good shape. I mean, until you've played a couple of games, you can't tell the speed of the game, the simulation of those type of deals up. My guess is we'll be winded a little bit early in that Friday afternoon game and, we'll sub some. But I think our guys will. We've had a good couple of days of practice. I think it'll be interesting to see what we have today and tomorrow. We'll practice tomorrow morning, then we'll head on over.
Coach, what kind of, protocols are they putting in place for this as far as hotel? And was the testing similar among the three programs, even though Belmont Abbey, is a D2? Is everybody pretty comfortable with that level of testing?
Well, they were adhering to Charlotte's testing protocol already, as well as ours. And that they are getting additional testing. We will test here tomorrow, then we will test Friday and Saturday, I think early mornings. I think we're both at 8 o'clock on Friday and Saturday morning to adhere to protocol, which our medical people want, as well as Charlotte's medical people want.
Coach, do you know your starting five yet, or are you going to keep that under wraps till Friday?
Well, if they're not telling me, I'm not telling them. So we're probably both in the same boat.
Coach, does this have an NCAA tournament type feel to it at all? I mean, you've obviously had a lot of experience with that. Just as far as scheduling kind of last minute preparing for an opponent, does it feel similar to that at all or no?
My guess is it could be like this, for a while. You might be, expected to play so-and-so, and it'll be – that's why we talk with our guys all the time. It's most importantly remembering your principles, because it's the same thing as during a game. If a team has a week to prepare for you, sometimes they have a few wrinkles that you haven't seen. So you've got to adjust to those quickly. You got to see what they're doing differently and make your team adjust to it. It is a quick turnaround. You know, the NCAA, it's usually just a, you know, you get this selection show on Sunday and you're probably on a plane Sunday or Monday, depending, I mean, on Monday or Tuesday, depending upon when you play. So being able, you know, we played last year, we had everything charted out. And as soon as we started the potential of playing this game, we started going through this, and Rock had pulled a bunch of stuff, you know, as soon as we found out, and we've been looking at it for a couple of days.
I don't know how much time you've had to talk to other coaches, but what have been kind of their frustrations in this first week or concerns in this first week, if you have had a chance to talk to your colleagues around the country?
Well, the people that I've talked to are concerned about, obviously, the contact tracing. You know, there's different, you know, depending upon where you live, there's different standards. You know, I think that's one thing. You know, if a tier one person tests positive, what was his contact tracing ability? I think that's one big thing. I think everybody's worried about the kids. I mean, I think the guys, you know, usually you put your head down and you're starting to play. Now it's, you know, they're also saying, well, we're going to play, but, you know, we could be like these other people and get games canceled. We've already had games canceled, or, you know, just the whole uncertainty, as opposed to let's just focus on, we're getting an opportunity to play. Let's get after it.
You know how important it is at East Carolina to get off to a fast start and mentally for this bunch and try to see if you can get a couple of wins on the board. Talk about that and just trying to get off to a good start.
Well, I think it's going to be like with everything else. It's going to be a weird, you know, I'm watching a couple of games here. We just walked back in the building and our guys are down getting ready to go lift. And I just think that with not having the exhibition games and, you know, not only that, for a while, not, you know, several of our guys, as well as I'm sure several of Charlotte's guys, you went through the summer where you probably weren't able to play pickup for a good stretch or play 5-on-5. So that's all different. One thing we do have is we're fortunate. We do have a lot of guys back from last year. It's 11 of the guys back from last year. I do think that some of the things that we've done, they've picked up a lot quicker and there's more of a familiarity. So I think they feel more confident and comfortable with it.
Coach, I know the American usually has a policy, I guess, to not play non-Division One, but I saw South Florida was playing, I think, Florida College today. Are they kind of waiving that policy with everything going on?
The way I understood it, you could do it in conjunction with an MTE, or you can get a waiver from the conference. I think with the scheduling difficulties that are going to happen, you know, with basketball, it's you know, there's usually playing two or three games a week. You know, there's going to be some people that have to be slid to different spots if games are shut down or if opponents are shut down. So I think they gave us some flexibility to play non-one this year.
Coach, can you provide some clarification about the status and eligibility of Navy transfer David Katsungani?
David's going to redshirt. He's going to sit out this year.
Coach, as far as like the season, is there a number of games that you feel like if you get that this amount in, that it'll be worth it, that the season will have been a success?
I think any games we get in, I you know, we obviously can't foresee the future, but I, you know, giving the guys an opportunity to play games and do this and do what they love to do, I think is a win in itself. So, you know, we'll just focus on worrying about, you know, getting to Friday, and after Friday, we'll worry about getting to Saturday, and we'll get these kids home on Saturday night, and then we'll start focusing on next week. I mean, there's so much uncertainty for all of us, but you know, let's put our heads down, let's go ahead and try to be safe, and let's keep rolling. Anything else, guys?
We're good, guys.
Well, like John Rothstein said, stay positive, test negative, guys. Let's keep rolling.
Thanks, Coach.
See you guys.